The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Not everyone who says to me, 'Lord, Lord,' will enter the kingdom of heaven, but only the one who does the will of my Father in heaven. Many will say to me on that day, 'Lord, Lord, did we not prophesy in your name? Did we not drive out demons in your name? Did we not do mighty deeds in your name?' Then I will declare to them solemnly, 'I never knew you. Depart from me, you evildoers.' Everyone who listens to these words of mine and acts on them will be like a wise man who built his house on rock. The rain fell, the floods came, and the winds blew and buffeted the house, but it did not collapse. It had been set solidly on rock. And everyone who listens to these words of mine but does not act on them will be like a fool who built his house on sand. The rain fell, the floods came, and the winds blew and buffeted the house, and it collapsed and was completely ruined." When Jesus finished these words, the crowds were astonished at his teaching, for he taught them as one having authority, not as their scribes. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters, chapters 5, 6, and 7 of the Gospel of St. Matthew contain Jesus' Sermon on the Mount. And the past 2 weeks, we have been reading, taking our Gospel from this section of the Gospel of St. Matthew, chapters 5, 6, and 7. And today's Gospel is the conclusion of Jesus' Sermon on the Mount. Jesus concludes his long teaching. And Jesus concludes his long teaching by saying to his listeners and to all of us the importance of not only listening to his words, but also putting them into practice. Pagkatapos niyang magturo ng napakaraming bagay, tinapos niya yung kanyang pagtuturo sa pagsasabi sa mga nakikinig sa kanya, "Hindi sapat na nakinig lang kayo, isabuhay niyo yung narinig niyo. Hindi sapat na natuwa lang kayo sa sinabi ko, isabuhay niyo yan, gawin ninyo sa inyong pang-araw-araw na buhay." And in order to prove his, to emphasize his point, Jesus used an analogy of two houses, and both houses were buffeted by rains, winds, and storm, floods. One house collapsed while the other house stood strong. And where lies the difference? On the foundation. One house was built on sand. And so when the rains, floods, and winds came, the house easily collapsed because the foundation is not strong. While the other house is built on rock. And so when the rains, the winds, and the floods came, the house stood strong because the foundation is strong. And Jesus says, the person who only listens to his words and do not put them into practice is like that man who built his house on sand. But the one who listens to his words and applies them to his life is like that man who built his house on rock. Even though there will be rains, floods, and winds, that person will stay strong. He will not collapse. That person will always survive. And the story of our first reading today proves this. King Jehoiakim of Judah was the last king of Judah before the kingdom of Judah fell into the Babylonians, and most of the people in the kingdom of Judah were exiled to Babylon. The reason is because King Jehoiakim and his people were not faithful to God. They built their kingdom not on the solid rock of God's will, but they built their kingdom on the sandy foundation of human will, of human interest, and human power. Itinayo nila yung kanilang kaharian sa kanilang pangalan at kapangyarihan lamang. And so when the strong storm of the Babylonian Empire came, led by its king, King Nebuchadnezzar, the kingdom of Judah easily collapsed and fell, and they were sent to exile because the foundation was not strong. My dear brothers and sisters, today Jesus invites us not only to listen to his words, but put them always into practice. And Jesus tells us that whoever follows his words, he does not promise an easy life. When we follow the word of God, when we follow the words of Jesus, it is not an assurance that life will be easy. When we follow the word of God, it is not an assurance that there will be no rains and storms and floods and strong winds that will buffet our lives. He does promise, however, that if we follow his words, if we make his words the foundation of our lives, then we will always survive. We will always stand strong. Yan ang pangako ni Jesus. Magiging matibay ang pundasyon ng ating buhay. Magiging matibay ang pundasyon ng ating pamilya kung ang pundasyon na yon ay ang salita ng Diyos na ating isinasabuhay. Today, my dear brothers and sisters, we celebrate the feast of our Mother of Perpetual Help, a devotion that is very close to the hearts of Filipinos. Marami po sa atin nagdadasal ng novena to our Mother of Perpetual Help every Wednesday. At marami sa atin pumupunta sa baklaran para magdebosyon sa ating mahal na ina. The Blessed Virgin Mary is a perfect example of a person who does not only listen to God's word, but applies it to her life. That is why Mary, the foundation of the life of Mary is God and obedience, fidelity to God's word. Kaya siguro mabisa ang panalangin ng mahal na ina dahil matibay ang pundasyon ng kanyang pananampalataya sa Diyos. Kaya siguro kapag nagdarasal tayo sa Kanya, mabisa ang kanyang panalangin para sa atin at ibinibigay ng Diyos ang biyayang hinihiling natin. Dahil sa buhay ni Maria, nakikita natin ang matibay na pundasyon ng kanyang pagsunod sa kalooban ng Diyos. And I'm sure all of us, especially the devotees of our Mother of Perpetual Help, have proven the power of Mary's intercession. Siguro bawat isa sa atin may kanya-kanyang kwento kung paanong ang pananalangin natin sa mahal na Birheng Maria ay nagbunga ng ipagkakaloob sa atin ng Diyos ng ating hinihinging biyaya. Alam niyo po, ako bilang pari ay nagdedebosyon din sa Mother of Perpetual Help. Every Wednesday, even as a priest, I pray the novena to our Mother of Perpetual Help. At ang debosyon pong ito ay nagsimula nung ako'y batang sakristan pa sa aming parokya. Tuwing Miyerkules, magnonovena ako at magsisimba. Nung seminarista po ako sa San Carlos Seminary, hindi naman bahagi ng schedule namin yung pagdarasal ng novena. Pero napansin po namin na pag Wednesday, merong kaming mga seminarista, individually, nasa chapel para magdasal ng novena to our Mother of Perpetual Help. Kaya minsan nag-usap-usap kami, sabi namin, total, pare-pareho naman tayo nagno-novena sa Perpetual Help. Bakit hindi sabay-sabay na tayong magdasal? And so we agreed that after lunch every Wednesday, we will gather in the chapel to pray the novena. Ibig sabihin po noon, we will forgo our siesta. Kasi after lunch, usually the schedule is siesta, and then at 2 o'clock, we will resume our classes. Kaya every Wednesday, we will sacrifice our siesta to pray the novena to our Mother of Perpetual Help. At alam niyo po, lahat kaming magkakasamang nagdarasal noon, voluntary lang naman, hindi kasama sa schedule ng seminaryo, kung sino lang ang may gusto na sumama, lahat kaming magkakasamang nagdasal ng Mother of Perpetual Help Novena, lahat kami naging pari. Kaya yung novenang prayers na yun, napakahalaga para sa amin dahil alam namin ang kapangyarihan ng mahal na Birheng Maria, ang ating ina ng laging saklolo. My dear brothers and sisters, there will always be rains, winds, and floods in our life. But they do not matter. They do not matter if we have a strong foundation. Kung matibay ang pundasyon, hindi dapat tayo matakot kung may bagyo, malakas na hangin o pagbahang dumarating sa ating buhay. Kaya tiyakin nating matibay ang ating pundasyon. Let us see to it that our foundation is God. God who is our refuge and our stronghold. Because in God, we will never collapse. In God, we will never be destroyed. In God, we will always stand strong.